what's the point about driving a 400 horsepower 911 Carrera S convertible when the temperature is a little bit above zero? With the kind of support that you guys have given me this year, my Boxer review has over 100,000 views. I felt like I owe you this review of the 991, and I did not want to finish a great season of reviews without having talked about this car and without having done a review on it. Couldn't get one from Porsche all year, which was sad, but I rented this one for a few days so that I can film it for you.
The new 991 shares only 10% of its parts with the old 997. That has to mean a lot, since so many people, including myself, said that the 997 was one of the greatest 911s of all time. So the body is now made of aluminium, the wheelbase has been extended, the track is wider, the wheels are 1 inch bigger, and the whole car sits lower to the ground. It weighs up to 60 kilograms less, so that a 991 Carrera S can run the same times on the Nürburgring as a 997 GT3.
Now, coming from such beauties as a 964, 993 or the 997, and designing a new 911 from the ground will always be a tough challenge. I have to say, my original feelings about the 991 were very similar to what I felt like when I first saw the 996. I wasn't hating it, but I didn't love it either.
The new design takes the 911 shape into the 21st century, but it could be one of the main reasons why many 997 owners now flirt with the idea of buying the new stunning looking Boxster instead of getting a new 911. The big gap between the door and the rear fender clearly shows where the extra 10 cm of wheelbase have been added, and begs for a turbo air intake to fill it.
It feels a little bit less rear-engined. And technically that makes complete sense, because the rear wheels have been moved backwards in relation to the position of the engine.
The new chassis is meant to make the 911 easier to drive, especially on the limit where most of its infamous understeer has been eradicated. And still, nothing quite matches the way it sticks to the road and absolutely fires out of corners.
Become such a fast car, man oh man. It really feels like the devil is sitting on my shoulder driving this car on these roads here. The engine is still the most thrilling part about driving a 911 for me. It's an absolute masterpiece, this flat six engine. They haven't really changed too much about it, but with this new PDK, it is a completely different driving experience than the 997s that I drove with the PDK. It's just so much more responsive. It's just an absolutely great system, this PDK of the second generation. It does everything for you. You can drive extremely economical with this car, with the coasting function in the normal mode. And when you decide to go into Sport, Sport Plus, or use the manual mode, I really don't have to say anything, do I? It's just the most responsive system that I have ever driven in comparison to other car makers. Now driving a 911, you have to work the front end much more than driving a Boxster fast, which is the reason why this electric steering doesn't work as good here for me as in the Boxster. It is not really lacking precision. As you can see, I don't have to do any corrections, but it's lacking a little bit of feel. And in the 911, with this rear engine design, you rely on those informations that you get from the front wheels. And Porsche has tried to change that with the new chassis, extended wheelbase, wider track, less understeer. It's all very impressive, but I have to say I still wish they would have kept the hydraulic system, or would at least offer it as an option. drive according to the speed limits here. And I think that could be a problem for some people. Here in Germany, where we have extremely generous speed limits, even on such twisty roads here, 100 kph or 62 miles per hour, you can still enjoy this car without having to take it to a racetrack and feel the differences between this car and the 997. But my concern is that when you're driving this car in a country where you're not allowed to drive that fast, then you could miss this mechanical feeling of the 997. Then driving a 991 is actually not as exciting as a 997, I guess. But that doesn't mean that this 911 is not a proper 911. It feels absolutely sensational.
The new interior of the 991 shows high-class materials and a build quality that only Audi can match. Thanks to the extended wheelbase, it offers a bit more space and still has the most driver-focused and comfortable seating position of any car I have ever driven. The only reason why I can't call it perfect is the new Panamera-style center console, which is a bit more distracting to use while driving than the one in the 997 used to be. Many of you have asked me if the new Boxster S is on the same level or even better than the 991. Well, to be honest, I think the new Boxster is a more instinctive driver's car to use on most public roads and easier to drive. As a puristic sports car, it feels a bit more authentic than this 911. And that's before we even talk about the fact that a Boxster costs half the money of this Carrera convertible. So I really can't blame anybody for buying a fully loaded Boxster S and making a good bargain over a standard 911. But, and this is quite a big but, for me a 911 still feels much more special to drive than the best roadster Porsche has ever made. The reasons are countless, but it comes down to the fact that for a real 911 fan like me, it doesn't have any other competition than itself.
In the end, I have to say, there is really no doubt about the fact that based on numbers, this is a faster, yet more economical, so all around better car than the 997. But I mentioned my original feelings about the 996 in the beginning for good reason, because I have to say, I'm not yet sure if this is a better 911 for me. And that's very different from what I first felt like getting into a 997. So I feel like this review isn't really over until Porsche has finally given me the chance to review a car with a 7-speed manual, preferably in the new Carrera 4, which they say drives even better, and the new manual gearbox also has a feature in the Sport Plus mode that automatically rev matches the downshifts, and that's something that I really would like to test, so maybe next year, I hope so. And if you guys enjoyed this review, please leave me a comment, tell me what you think about this car. And I see you next year. Take care, guys.